our first Prism concert, a little word about what we've been doing and what we're doing this evening. Ever since Marchu season ended, we've broken up into the small ensembles that you'll see in front of you this evening. The idea of a Prism concert is not unique or original to me. It's one that's being done around the country as more and more band programs try to expand and do things for the musicians and the instrumentalists playing in their groups. It's one thing to play in an ensemble of 115 people. And for those of you who've done that, you know that experience. But for those of you who have also done an ensemble of five, it's quite a different experience. So we've developed, you won't hear all of them this evening, but we've developed about 13 different instrumental ensembles that have been, that have derived from the concert band. And through the help of Mrs. Fajak, Mrs. Saywood, and a student teacher, Mr. Gallagher from the University of New Hampshire, we've worked with them on a daily basis. The benefits are numerous. Working on one-on-one on a part, working in small ensembles, working on new literature, working on a lot of things that we don't have the opportunity to work on when there are 15 clarinets in a section and 12, 15 trumpets, has afforded some of our students the opportunity to kind of expand. It's impossible to do something with everyone just because of limitations of space, time, and personnel. But we have developed quite a few, and we hope to do that this evening. The idea of the Prism, one light coming through the Prism and then branching off into many different areas of the color spectrum, and that's the idea here. So, the band is a wonderful place to develop instrumentalists, and that's an important function that we have. Chamber music and this type of an ensemble is a really wonderful vehicle to not only develop instrumentalists, but to develop musicians, and that's tough. But in this type of setting, it makes it a little bit easier, because we get to work one-on-one with some of the kids. So, the first group we'd like to have, for those of you without the benefit of programming, is our Brass Quintet 2. They're going to play the Hawk Bell Cannon.
Thank you.
quartet, and they're going to be playing a piece by Mozart called Contradans. Close enough. Contradans.
Not a
Mozart. Not a cast. Right. Blue quartet. Another piece by Mozart, this is called Allegro Molto.
Thank you.
our flute quartet one, and they're going to be playing two short selections. The first one is a minuet by Bach, and the second piece is entitled Song by Mendelssohn.
Thank you.
entitled Three Shades of Blue.
Thank you.
draw your attention to the back page of the program. That tells us what's going to be happening for the next little bit. And a few words of explanation may be in order. Saturday for the high school, Friday for the middle school band is large group competition at Manchester Memorial High School. It is a free and open event, and you're willing, if you want to attend, you're certainly welcome to do so. There are directions on your way out. Write to Memorial, Manchester Memorial, not Central or West. Manchester Memorial, the band, high school band plays at 10:30. The orchestra plays at, what, 9:30? 9:30. The chorus performs at 1:25 and 3:25, all for the high school. We do have something, again, a little we haven't done before. On April 23rd, I'd like to draw your attention to a concert at the Methuen Memorial Music Hall in Methuen, Massachusetts. If you've not been to the facility, it's absolutely gorgeous. It is truly a world-renowned, without any exaggeration, music facility right over here in Methuen, Massachusetts. Very unpretentious from the outside, doesn't look like much. Alan's back. And April 23rd. Now, this is the Woodwind Quintet 1, and they're going to be performing what? Another piece by Mozart called Overture to the Marriage of Figaro. Thank you. next and last of the small ensembles is our Dixieland Combo.
Thank you.
Before we do our last number, I just want to interject a little commercial on behalf of the middle school music department. On May 16th, they're hosting the middle school, or junior high, I guess it's still called in the state of New Hampshire, All-State at our middle school. That's why they're hosting it. And they're going to need some help. They're going to need some parental help. We have to get meals for how many people?
200.
And chaperoning and all those type of things. If you'd like to help out, I'm sure many of your sons and daughters were involved in that in other schools. Well, it's our turn to host. They can certainly use your assistance in that. Mr. Clark is here, and there is a form, I believe, right here, that we'll pass around during the last song, real quiet. And we'll put it on a music stand over here. Just, we need a drop-off spot for that, too. We're not quite organized with that. If we could just give it to Mr. Clark at the end, or Mrs. Pajak, or Mr. Saywood, or myself. There's forms there for food and chaperoning, and you know the drill. They could really use the help. Thank you for being such a great audience this evening in our little first-time experiment with the Prism concert. We hope you enjoyed that. One thing, as I said at the top of the concert, to play in a band of 120, it's quite another thing to go up here and be one of five or four or six and have to carry your own part and take care of the music. There's no place to hide, no place to run, and you're there. And it's a wonderful character building experience, so thank you. Our last number is a piece called Chorale and Shaker Dance, and it's built upon the American folk tune, 'Tis a Gift to Be Simple. We hope you enjoy it by John Sedeli.